Well, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Notch Creek Baptist Church. So glad you joined us tonight. There is a big crowd here this evening. So I know you guys sit closer than this at ball games, so try to scooch in if you can. Even if you don't like the person next to you and you're married to them, let's try to sit closer together. But we do appreciate you coming out tonight, and we appreciate, there'll be more thank yous later, but appreciate Sarah putting this together. No, it takes a lot of hard work and a lot of time spent practicing and various things, so we'll do some more thank yous later. I did want to mention to the church family, the Troy McConkie family, we'll get some arrangements sent out on that tomorrow once we have all those, or tonight once we have those. So we'll get all those arrangements sent out and keep you informed on that. So just tonight, we hope you can worship with us through laughter. I don't think there are going to be a lot of tears shed tonight unless you're laughing that hard you're crying. But we did want you to know that this altar is open at any point. If you need to come pray or do business with God, this cast will stop. They'll meet you in the altar. Someone will come pray with you and support you. And I wanted to read just a couple of verses to you here real quick. One thing as a church that we have committed to, and that's upholding the Word of God. And we're not going to back down from what the Word says, and we take it seriously. But there are times when we need to just loosen up a little bit and laugh at both ourselves, things going on around us, and have a little fun in a Christian way. Read you a couple of verses here. Psalm chapter 126, verse 2 says, "Then was our mouth filled with laughter and our tongue with singing. Then said them among them, the Lord hath done great things for them. The Lord hath done great things for us. Wherefore we are glad." I don't know about you, but the Lord's done a great work in my life. It's blessed me very richly, blessed this church very richly. So let's have a little laughter. Let's have some fun in the Lord. And let's go to the Lord in prayer. And then we're going to open with a quick video just to set up things. And then we'll get into the place. Let's pray. Father, we just come to you tonight. We just thank you, Lord, for all the blessings that you've given us. And Father, this church, how you blessed it richly. We ask you to be with Pastor Shane as he recovers, Father. We just ask you to be with him. And Father, this play, we just ask you to use it mightily. And you just speak in the way that you want to be heard tonight. And Father, use this cast for your glory. And everything we do at this church, we want it to be for your glory and your glory alone. Forgive us where we fail you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
For Easter this year, Cousin Elkin?
You know, Fester, I don't know. I've been pondering on it a fair bit, and I was figuring we ain't been to see our city cousins in a long time. Dread it all.
All they want to do is try to get their hands on their money every time they come to see us, especially that Mimi and that Petunia.
Now, Grandma.
Hey, I got an idea. Why don't we go to the city this year for Easter?
Fester, that's just what I just said. Gunk hat.
Hey, what are y'all talking about?
Well, we was thinking about going to the city for Easter.
We are? I get to see Cousin Oswald?
And Peter and the girls too, honey.
Yay!
Well, guys, it looks like if we wait for an invitation, we'll be waiting forever.
That's a fact.
So let's just head on up to that fancy church in the city.
I can't wait to see their faces when it comes.
Surprise!
Mister, I do like your skunk hat, bro. I do.
Tell Philip those financial reports must be turned in by in the morning. I know it's Easter. I don't know what you want me to do about the calendar. Well, they better get in before the morning. Morning.
Yeah.
Oh, happy Easter, I guess.
Whatever.
Can you believe Philip still doesn't have the financial reports turned in? And he tried to use Easter as an excuse, something about spending time with his family. I don't know what the world's coming to. There, how do I look?
Handsome.
Yeah, you got that right.
Okay, is everybody ready?
Mimi is about to come out and show us her Easter dress. Just no matter what it looks like, let's go on about it. Ready, Mimi?
Well, what do you think?
Beautiful. You'll be the most beautiful girl in church.
Yeah, what he said.
I am so excited about this year's Easter dress. It's an original design by Brookshire. Oh, my goodness. The Sharon Brookshire. Oh, my goodness. I just can't wait. There's not another one like it, guys.
I'm sure.
It's a couture. I was so lucky to get it.
Oh, everyone will be talking about your style, I guess. I mean, that is the point, I guess.
Well, of course it's the point, Silly Willie. Come on now. Wait a minute. Where is Petunia at? Has she not even modeled yet?
Not yet.
Oh, my goodness. That girl, she is purposefully just keeping me in suspense this year.
What do you mean?
We never show each other our dresses. It's always a surprise.
You two are so competitive.
I am not competitive. I am fine, honestly, with anything that she wears, as long as it doesn't look better than mine.
Sounds just like a woman. I mean, you don't see me and Oswald competing over our wardrobe, do you?
That's because you don't have Fantasia Golding looking at everything you wear.
Who is Fantasia Golding?
Honestly, Pete, she goes to our church. You honestly don't know? She comes in every Sunday with her little journal like she's taking sermon notes. I know what she's up to.
No.
Oh, yes, she does. She comes waltzing in, and she sits down there, and she just sits down, and she writes down everything we're wearing, who we sit by.
You don't say.
Oh, you know what?
Every Sunday?
You two are, you just have no sympathy. You don't even know.
Is everyone ready?
Here comes Petunia. Listen, I know she's not going to have a Brookshire dress this year, but we're going to pretend it still looks good, okay?
We'll try to be tactful.
Okay. Hey, Petunia, we're ready? Here she comes. I'm so excited.
Well, what do you think?
They're speechless.
Two women who can't talk. This might be a decent Easter after all.
Petunia, your dress.
Mimi, your dress.
Well, they're talking again.
I knew it wouldn't last.
Mimi, what are you doing wearing my dress?
Your dress? You go march right back in there this instant and you change.
I was about to suggest you do the same.
It's Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
I am not changing.
Well, neither am I.
Good, because we don't have enough time. We're going to be late for church. It's Easter. The church is going to be packed.
Have you lost your mind, Oswald? I mean, you know the girls like to make an entrance.
Well, it doesn't look like we're going to be making an entrance at all this year.
What are you talking about?
You don't think we can attend Easter Sunday service dressed the exact same, do you?
Well, then one of you will just have to change.
Mm-hmm. Did you hear that, Mimi? I guess you better scoot off and go change.
He was talking to you.
Good grief. Here, look. Let's do this. All right. We will draw straws, and the loser will have to change. Agreed?
Well.
Come on. Come on.
Come on.
Good.
I guess that'll be all right.
All right. Here. All right. Draw, Petunia.
Why does she get to go first?
Fine. You draw.
Wait. Why does she get to go first?
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Yeah, for my sake.
Shut up, Pete.
Okay, Mimi can draw.
Okay, so the small one loses?
The small one loses.
Okay. Let me see. I really don't know.
Mimi!
Hurry.
I won!
Okay, Mimi, go change. We gotta get going.
So what?
So Fantasia Golding is going to be watching.
Well, I guess Fantasia Golding will have to get over it.
This is going to be the worst. This will be the worst Easter in the whole history of the world. I'm just so upset.
Bye.
Oh. Gosh, you girls are just so worried about what Fantasia Golding thinks of you.
Yeah, Petunia, do you even know what the sermon was about last week?
Of course I do. It was about, you know what? You need to mind your own business.
Yeah, Oswald, I mean, you're just as bad. I mean, the only reason you've been going to church lately is so you could get that contract from Mr. What's-his-name?
Mr. Crandall. And listen, if I get that contract, it's a big bonus at work. It's well worth it. Okay?
Uh-huh. See, you are just as bad.
So, Pete's no better. The only reason he goes to church is to flirt with that girl that sits in front of him.
Her name is Natalie. I mean, no, I don't. I do not.
Yeah.
Well, we're all hypocrites, so...
Mimi, hurry up. Let's go. We're going to be late if we're going to get a good parking spot. We got to go.
Hey, move over. I need to look at my hair one more time.
Hey, both of y'all, move over. I need to see what my new dress looks like. Oh,
you got that lint roller?
Don't use it on my dress.
No, I'm not
using it. It'll take my feathers off.
Did you brush your teeth?
I think I forgot.
I do think you forgot. Yeah.
You got a breath mint? Got a Tic Tac or something?
You need to be quiet now.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're being rude.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, no.
A bow tie straight.
Surprise! That's good.
See, Granny, I told you they'd be excited to see us.
Happy Easter, City Cousins!
Are you surprised? I bet you are, ain't you? We really got you goat. Yeah.
We got you.
Oh,
all right.
Look, Cousin Oswald, you're standing under the mistletoe.
Hey, I wanted a kiss on Cousin Oswald.
Brenda May, Glenda May, you two straighten up and act like somebody.
Yeah, and besides, that mistletoe's for Christmas, not Easter.
Well, as long as I get me some sugar, I don't care what day it is.
Need
Grandma
to move
Taylor,
that cage.
Elkin. What are you guys doing in the city?
Well, Cousin Petunia, it's kind of like this. Y'all are always coming out to Cricket County to spend time with us.
And to try to get you grubby little hands on our money.
Grandma!
Well.
Anyhow, we thought best thing we could do this year was the least we could do was come spend Easter Sunday with you all.
Mm-hmm. Well, now that you mention it, did you happen to bring any of that money with you?
Petunia.
Well, you know, they have millions. And it's obvious they don't spend none of it on themselves.
Obviously.
Well, you're just a little bit jealous because Uncle Zeke left us all this land chock full of gold mines, diamond mines, and oil fields.
Don't remind me. I think I'm getting a migraine.
Oh, well, Grandma said we'd be waiting forever if we was waiting for an invitation. So we just decided to pack up and pick up. And come on up!
Yeah.
Surprise.
Yeah, that's
Surprise. Mm-hmm. Surprise.
Surprise?
Surprise!
Surprise!
Fester, we've already said that.
Yeah, well, you see, Grandma, it's just that we were, I guess what I'm...
What Pete's trying to say is we're so glad to see you all, but we're really just not prepared for company right now.
Yeah, seems like we're just all a victim of bad timing here. See, I think that we were like on our way to go see the church and Easter service this morning, so...
Heck, we ain't company, we're kinfolk.
Right, because like they say in the country, if it looks like a duck and quacks like a duck, it must be time for supper, and I bet you a dollar we're having duck.
You're right, of course. You all are family, and you're welcome as always.
But we're about to head off to church. I mean, we kind of need to go, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Well, did you hear that, Clan? You know what they're doing? They're going to Easter service. Yes. Dread it all.
Tell them, Fester.
You mean I get the honor?
Would you please do the honors?
Guess what? We're going to church with you.
Surprise! Don't that just boil you grits? I bet you ain't had that many surprises in one day.
Can you excuse us for one moment, please?
God, they're so happy, Granny.
What are we going to do?
Did you see the look on our face?
Got him. If they come to church with us, Mr. Crindle's going to see them.
Natalie won't give me the time of day if she sees them with us.
Fantasia Golding will never let us live this down.
All right, just follow my lead, okay?
Okay.
Oh, man, we are so glad you all came to visit us, but unfortunately, you know, we're running a little late, and we really don't have enough time for you all to change.
Change?
Yes, ma'am, into your Easter clothes.
Why, you silly rabbit. These are Easter clothes. Yeah. We had them made up special just for Easter Sunday preaching.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't they dress up fancy like this in the city?
Exactly.
You know what I just thought about?
Just tell them what you thought about, Petunia.
Well, we forgot all about Easter dinner.
Oh, man.
Hey, I thought we always
You're absolutely right, Petunia. We forgot about Easter dinner. Drat it all.
Yeah, whatever are we going to do?
If only we had someone who could stay and prepare the meal for us. Oh, no.
If only we knew someone who had a diner, was used to cooking for a lot of people, you know, someone who's in the cooking business.
Honey, how can I help you think of somebody when you're gabbing in my ear?
Yeah.
Now just hold on here, cotton picking minute. Everybody knows Grandma's used to cooking for lots of people.
Well, that's true.
Why, yeah. She had her own very own eating place down there in Ray County.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, Grandma, that is so nice of you to offer.
What did I offer?
To stay back and cook us Easter dinner.
Did I do that?
Yes.
But we can't leave Grandma here all by herself while the rest of us go to church.
No, that wouldn't be nice at all.
Oh, man, you're right. It wouldn't be nice at all. If only someone could stay and help her get everything prepared. I mean, I just don't know who that could be.
Heck, me and Glenda May's pretty handy in the kitchen. Hint, hint.
Yeah, hint, hint.
Well, now, everybody, I just had my heart setting on going to Easter service this morning.
Well, that's just it, Grandma. You can still go to church with us.
Well, how you figure that?
Well, every Sunday our church service is broadcast, and you can sit right here and watch it on our 75-inch TV screen.
Wow. Yeah. See, we offer these 3D glasses, so it's like you're right there in the worship center.
Well, all right then, if you don't like my cooking that much.
Oh, there you go.
I can't wait to taste it.
I know it's going to be delicious.
You're going to love Grandma's cooking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, in Cricket County, she was voted Cook of the Year for the month of April. Yeah.
That's right.
And don't you fret, Grandma. We'll be glad to help you.
Like I said, we're real domestic.
I'm just like the
girl next door. If you happen to live next door to a dog pound.
Well, okay. Is everybody ready?
We forgot about Mimi.
She'll have a fit if she sees them here. 1 second, Mimi.
Grandma, hey, the kitchen's right through here. Let me show you the way.
Come on, fam. Let's go in here and check out this fancy kitchen.
Yeah, right through this door, right through here. This way, this way. Yeah, that's right.
There we go.
Where's he going?
All right, guys.
Hester.
This
way. That way.
Wait, 1 second, Mimi. Yeah, okay.
Wait.
Crazy.
Okay, now, ready or not, here I come. Well, what do you think?
Mimi, that is my dress.
I know.
But I haven't worn it yet.
I know. I only looked at the ones that had tags on them.
You can't wear my dress before I wear my dress.
Petunia, it was your idea that I change.
Under the circumstances, Petunia, I think it'll be okay.
Besides, we're going to be late if we don't get going.
Why is there an axe in our living room?
All right, everybody, let's get going to church.
Yes, let's go. Come. Why, Mr.
Mimi, stay calm.
Well, hey, Cousin Mimi. I didn't even see you standing in there. Hey, cuz, Granny wants to know where the wood is for the stove.
There is no wood, Fester.
Granny's here? Yes.
He says there ain't no wood.
I want to know how in the world am I supposed to cook that wood for the stove?
It's an electric stove, Grandma.
Oh, my goodness. Look at here if it ain't old Moo Moo. Happy Easter, honey. Look at that dress. Oh, Lord. You look like one of them there movie stars.
I do.
Hey, Grandma. Grandma.
Yes.
How much flour do we need?
Look.
It's Cousin Mimi.
Yeah, get a word.
Oh, look how pretty you are. Oh, look at your dress. You're so pretty. You look like a deer standing in a field.
Yeah.
Who gets shot, gutted, stuffed, and then mounted on a wall above somebody's fireplace.
Yeah. That's what she looks like.
That's pretty.
Yeah.
That is.
I'm pretty.
As a hog in mud.
She's pretty.
She's pretty. Hey, Brenda. Brenda, come here.
Brenda, I'm sorry. What is it, Glenda May?
Look at Mimi's dress. Ain't she pretty?
My, oh, my, Cousin Mimi. Why, you're prettier than a deer standing in a...
I done told her that.
Oh.
Duh.
Well, hold on a minute, girls. What about my dress?
Bless her heart.
Well, I do hate to rush off, but the old clock is ticking, you know. We got to get going right along here.
Oswald, they're not going to church with us.
No, Mimi, they're not going. They're just staying here to take care of Easter lunch, okay?
Oh, thank goodness. I was afraid that...
What did you say?
She means thank goodness someone was so thoughtful to think about Easter lunch for us.
Yes.
Yeah.
Grandma, you and the women folk, we'll see y'all at the preaching. Pete, Cousin Oswald, we better get going.
Where are you all going?
No.
Well, you don't expect us to stay here and cook, do you?
Well, yeah.
Of course not, Fester. Well, everybody in the free world knows that cooking's a woman's work.
But I cook all the time.
Yeah.
So do I.
Well, you sissy boys, stay here and cook.
us men. We go to church with women.
No. No. Would everyone please wait a minute? If you guys go to church, who is going to stay back and help Grandma set the table, light the candles, get everything ready for our Easter dinner?
Well, now, it's just right as rain.
Yeah.
Fester, you and Elkin can stay here and help.
Okay. Long as I ain't got to wear Pete's apron.
All right, now, you city folks, you better get a move on, or you ain't going to hear no preaching today if you don't go on.
Well, there ain't going to be nobody doing nothing except for looking at how fancy Cousin Mimi is in her fancy Easter dress.
Yeah, because like we say in the country, when you dress up the prize heifer, the rest of the animals just can't hold a candle.
That's right.
And I ain't never seen a more prettier heifer in all my born days.
All right, everybody, we will we'll see you all after church.
Y'all get moved.
Thanks for your help with the food. Thank you.
Bye.
Go on, have a good time.
Sing pretty.
Bye. See ya. Like chicken.
We'll make herself at home.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. God, they're excited.
Hey, word. Bloodfay's really surprised.
I got to tell you, I'm just a little bit surprised. I never thought in a bajillion years you'd ever miss Easter Sunday preaching.
And I ain't going to this year.
Well, what do you mean, Grandma?
Well, I wanted it to be a surprise. I had to do everything like secret-like.
had to do what like secret-like?
Well, last night, when everybody left the diner, I went in there and I cooked up a sled load of food, put it in the bowls, covered it up, and put it in the back of the truck.
Do you mean to tell me the entire Easter dinner's out there in the back of my red truck?
Yeah. All we have to do is go out there and get it, take it to the kitchen, and warm her up.
I can't wait to see the surprise look on their faces when we come walking in.
You mean we do get to go to church with our city cousins?
Mm-hmm.
I get to sit by Cousin Oswald.
I want to sit by him, too.
I do, too.
Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do.
Okay.
We're going to wait till they all get in there and sit down. Then we're just going to come on in there behind them. When we get in there, we're going to say, surprise!
Yay!
Oh, it's going to be good.
Yeah, it's going to be good.
But wait, what about our Easter bonnets?
Oh, but never fear, Grandma is here.
You know, oh, Fester, if they going to put on Easter bonnets, we probably ought to change hats.
Good idea.
Yeah. That looks better on you anyway.
Oh, we're going to be the cast me out.
That's it, man. We're going to look in sharp.
Oh, I can't wait to see their look.
Nah, I can't.
Okay.
Wait. Let's go.
Well, ready? Family, shall we go to church?
We shall.
Up from the grave he rose with the mighty triumph over his foes.
Did that just happen?
Please tell me that was all just a bad dream.
Then why can't I wake up?
I pinched myself the whole way home.
That could only mean one thing.
It actually happened.
They came to our church.
They sat with us.
They shouted, "Surprise!" at the top of their lungs.
They sat with us.
They volunteered to recite an Easter poem.
They sat with us.
Fester actually stood up in front of our church and read a poem that he wrote.
Fantasia Golding saw them.
Mr. Crandall saw them.
Beautiful Natalie even saw them.
There, there, Mimi. Be okay.
No, it won't. It'll never be all right as long as I live.
How can we ever face our pastor again?
We'll just have to move to another city. It's that simple.
Somewhere far, far away, away from the eyes of that judgmental Fantasia Colby.
I mean, what made Fester think he could just stand up right there in the middle of our sacred service and recite an Easter poem that he wrote?
There he was, standing up there in that atrocious little hillbilly outfit of his, and he stood there in front of everybody we know. Everybody in this community, wealthy people, intelligent people, and he stood there and he just, oh, Oswald, I'm so mad.
But you know what was worse than that? When everybody at the church realized that they were with us.
Somebody get that. I'm too tired to move.
I'll get it. Hello? Oh, hello, Pastor Green. It's Pastor Green. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.
Well?
Pete, what did Pastor Green say?
Well? He said, first he said, "Is this Peter?" And I said, "Yes, sir." And then he said, "Is your family home?" And I said, "Yes, sir." And then he said, "Is it okay if my wife and I stop by to pay you all a visit?" And I said, "Yes, sir." And he said, "Okay, see you soon." And I said, "Okay, sir. Thank you." And I hung up.
Pete, what were you thinking?
Pete.
The hillbillies will be back any minute.
Calm down. Everybody calm down. Listen, we don't know why the prestigious pastor of the most illustrious church in the city would be coming over to see us. I mean, did he sound mad?
No, he didn't sound mad.
There you go. That's
good. He sounded furious.
Oh, bar the front door.
No, wait, wait. I got a better idea. Let's just all get in the car and leave.
Okay, good idea.
No, listen, listen. We can't do that. It wouldn't be right to leave after we tell the pastor and his wife that we're here. I mean, well, they're on our way over. It wouldn't be ethical or moral.
Well, then what are we going to do?
We lie.
We lie?
We tell them some hillbillies wandered in and some hobos off the street and just pretended that they knew us.
Do you think that'll work?
Of course it'll work. What do you think I've gotten here?
I don't know. Sounds pretty hollow to me.
Get the door.
Oh, Grandma.
Silly boy, you locked the door behind you. I guess that was by mistake.
Sorry, Grandma.
Boy, cuz, it sure was a good thing we was there living up your church today.
Bless y'all's heart. I ain't never been to something more boring in all my born days.
We prefer to consider it reverent.
Well, honey, I don't know how to tell you this, but your church service was colder than a day-old dumpling.
Oh, it was pretty as all get out, yeah. But it was colder than a hairless cat on a Christmas storm.
But Fester, you stood up in the middle of our sacred service and recited an Easter poem that you wrote. That was very presumptuous.
I'm glad you liked it. Much obliged.
Much obliged? Uh-oh. Much obliged. Much obliged?
You're welcome.
Oh, Oswald, I cannot take this another minute.
Mamie, settle down.
And Grandma, you promised that you were going to stay here and that you were going to make the Easter dinner and all of this stuff.
Now, honey, that's our second surprise. Yes. We brought all the victuals with us. All we have to do is heat it up and we'll be fine.
Surprise!
Fester, we said surprise enough already.
Now, you see, our very distinguished pastor and his wife, well, you see, they're on their way here, and you need to go.
Honey, we're just set two more plates, and they can eat with us.
Oh. Family, can I see you for a moment, please?
Well, Oswald, how are you going to handle this? We certainly can't allow our illustrious pastor and his wife to come over here and see those hillbillies.
He'll know for sure they're our family.
We're going to have to keep them all in the kitchen.
I think their preacher's coming over.
This ain't good at all.
How can we face him? He's bound to ask us how we like the service.
We just have to tell him. It's like watching paint dry.
It sure was.
We'll do no such thing. Remember what Mama always told us? Well, if you can't say something nice, keep your trap shut.
Well, now this is what we'll do. When he comes over and he mentions his old boring sermon that he preached, we'll just say nothing.
Say nothing.
Nothing.
Got it.
Nothing.
All right. Operation Keep Them in the Kitchen is now underway.
Operation Zip Your Lip. Starts now.
Ready?
Break!
Break!
Oh, Grandma Taylor, man, my stomach sure is a rumbling.
Yeah, Grandma, we can't wait to sink our teeth into some of them thar vittles you brought. Right, girls?
Right, y'all!
Oh, what's that? They'll be right there.
Who you talking to, Cousin Oswald?
Oh, the stove called, wondering when y'all would be in there to start lunch.
The stove.
That was a little joke.
That's a good one.
Well, that little joke wasn't a bit funny, but I'll tell you what, we'll go in there, heat it up. That's all we have to do, except for the biscuits now. I couldn't make them ahead of time.
Well, you take all the time you need. I mean, we're really not that hungry.
No.
I thought your joke was funny, Cousin Oswald. I was laughing on the inside.
All right. Remember, we have got to keep them all in the kitchen, okay?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, there they are. I think I'm going to faint. It's
okay. Hey, did I hear a cowbell? I didn't know you had cows.
We don't. That's the doorbell. It means someone's at the door faster. Hey, I'll take care of it. You just you get right back in that kitchen, okay?
Okay. Oswald, get the door.
Why me?
Why not?
Well, I'm certainly not going to get it.
Oh, good grief. Okay, everyone, settle down. I'll get the door. You guys act normal.
Okay.
Normal.
Ready? Okay.
Is
my hair okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Is
this
okay?
Hello. Hello. Welcome to our humble home. We're so glad you're here.
May we come in?
Oh, yes, of course. Come in. How rude of me. Where are my manners? Look, Oswald, it's Pastor Green and his gracious wife. I love your dress.
Thank you. And I just love your dress, Mimi.
Oh, this whole thing. Oh, my goodness. Thank you. You know, some Sunday mornings you just wake up and you're running late and you just don't even know what you're going to put on. And thank you, sweetie. That just means so much.
Come in, Pastor. May we take your jacket?
No, thank you. We won't be staying long.
Have a seat, won't you, please?
Yes, here. Oh, gosh. Have a seat. Yes, thanks. Sit down.
To be quite honest with you, this visit may be a little awkward.
Awkward, sir?
Yes, it's about the visitors you all had at our church this morning.
Visitors? Oh, you must mean those hillbillies this morning. You thought they were with us? No, sir. We've never seen them before today.
You haven't?
Oh, no, no. No, they just must have, like, wandered in off of the street or something.
No, we could not have asked them to leave, could we? Yeah.
Of course not.
You know, it's just that at the First Church of the Stained Glass, we have a certain way of doing things that they might not fully appreciate, and I use a lot of eloquent speech in my sermons, and I'm not sure they would understand what we were saying.
We're afraid that could result in confusion for them.
And you know, the Bible says that God's not the author of confusion.
Yes, He does. Oh. Thank you, Jesus.
You are Pastor, you are absolutely right. And, you know, I mean, simpletons off the street, they could never understand your sophisticated rhetoric, prattle, your...
I'm glad you understand.
Oh, yes.
And it does make us feel better that you appreciate where we're coming from. Yes.
Of course. I mean, I'm sure we'll never hear from those poor souls again.
Nice. What was that?
Mimi, did you remember to...
The dog.
Yeah.
The dog.
Mimi, did you remember to tie up the dog?
We don't have a dog.
Jamie.
I bet he got loose.
I bet he did.
Come on, Mimi, we'll go.
Oh, my goodness.
Check
back
on the dog.
That silly dog, he's always knocking things around, you know.
Well, you know, we happen to be avid dog lovers.
What's the dog's name?
Rover.
Bob.
Bob?
Rover.
Actually, his name is Rover Bob. Now, Rover Bob, you quiet down in there, okay?
Oh, he sounds so cute. May we see him?
I wouldn't go in there if I were you.
Why not?
Yeah, why not?
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll go get Rover Bob and bring him out. He needs to get out of the kitchen anyway.
Yeah, like I always say, if you can't stand the heat, stay out of the kitchen.
Stop helping me here, Pete.
So, how about this weather we're having? Yeah.
Cloudy.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. It seems that Rover Bob is asleep right now, so maybe you can see him next time you come for a visit.
That'll work. Oswald, Fester told me to tell you that...
Not now, Mimi.
Who is Fester?
Oh, that's our dog.
I thought your dog's name was Rover Bob.
Fester's our other dog. Sit, Fester, sit.
Now, wait a minute. You said Fester told me. You mean this Fester dog talks?
Well,
there's something awful strange going on here.
Isn't Fester the name of that hillbilly who recited that poem in this morning service?
Hey, somebody holler for me.
Oh.
Oh, hey, you must have been the one at the door. I thought you was a cow.
I beg your pardon?
I said, I thought you was a cow.
Mr. Tippenheimer, could you please ask whoever's in your kitchen to come out here?
But, sir, yes, sir.
Don't blame them, sir. I mean, really, they didn't mean any harm.
Strange one.
I want to know what in tarnation's going on out here. I have got to get these vittles on the table.
Yeah, what's the matter, Cousin Oswald?
Pastor Green, Mrs. Green, I'd like to introduce you to Fester, Elkin.
Ma'am.
Brenda May, Glenda May.
Hi.
And Grandma Taylor. Our family from Cricket County.
Family?
Well, that explains a lot now, doesn't it?
Don't touch me.
Ma'am, the first thing I'd like for you to explain to me is this. Are you or are you not the group of rabble-rousers who intruded upon our morning's Lenten service and discoursed such a rustic elegy as you did from our sacred pulpit? Can you explain that to me?
Well, first, you're going to have to explain what you just said.
Yeah. That's right, Grandma.
Just what I thought. Someone who can't appreciate the fine art of syntax construction. What do you have to say for yourself, Mr. Tippenheimer?
Well,
look, if you're mad because you wasn't invited to Easter dinner, that ain't a problem. We're just going to add two more plates.
Excuse me. Hello?
Mr. Green, Pastor Green.
Yes, who is this?
Sir, it's Mr. Quest, the church treasurer.
Look, I'll have to call you back. I'm in the middle of something.
Wait, I think you're going to want to hear this.
Okay, go ahead.
That hillbilly, the one that recited the poem this morning, wasn't his last name Taylor?
I don't remember. Hold on a minute. Excuse me. You have any ID?
About what?
No. ID, you know, as in identification. What's your name?
Taylor. Fester Taylor, sir.
Yes, it's Taylor. Why are you asking?
Well, we were counting the offering from this morning's service, and we came across a check.
Can you get to the point?
Well, Pastor, the check was written for $50,000.
Well, what's so special about $1,000?
No, you don't understand. It's $50,000, and it was signed by Elkin Taylor.
$50,000? Elkin Taylor?
Yes, sir.
Now listen, I Googled these people, and it seems like they just received a big inheritance from a rich uncle. They're worth millions.
Well, thank you for that information.
Pastor, how can you ever forgive us for trying to deceive you in this way?
Now, where was I? Oh, yes, I was just saying what a privilege it was to have you and your family at our church this morning.
Thank you, preacher.
A privilege? What are you saying?
I'm saying that we would love to stay and break bread with these fine people on Easter.
Well, it sure did take you long enough to say it. Now, I've got to get back to this kitchen and get this meal going here.
But, dear lady, you're a guest here. You shouldn't be working so hard on Easter Sunday.
Well, how do you think that this meal's going to get on the table if I don't put it on there?
Well, that's easy. My wife will do it.
That's right. His wife. Me!
Well, you don't mind, do you, dear? After all, we are servants of the Lord's people.
Well, move. Oswald, we can't let her do something like that now, can we?
Absolutely not. Can we, Pete?
I should say not.
Pete will do it instead.
That's right. Pete will. Me?
Yeah, you're a real sport, Pete.
But I don't know how to.
We'll help you, Cousin Pete.
We'll show you everything.
Uh-oh. Nonsense. You all are guests here, too. Make yourselves comfortable.
What is this all about?
Reddit.
Oh, gosh, don't touch me. Like my husband said, make yourselves comfortable. Have a seat, please.
Well, if you insist.
I insist. Have a seat.
Brenda May, get yourself back in there in that kitchen.
But she insisted.
The pastor's wife is right, Grandma Taylor. I mean, you all are our guests here, so you should take a load off.
You have a seat, too, Grandma. You know, sit down. Let's put your feet up. You want me to get you
away
face?
From me. Oh, gosh. Now, preacher Blue?
It's green.
Whatever. Now, you're that pastor up at that church we went to this morning?
Yes, ma'am, that's me.
We would love to know what you all thought of the service this morning. What about you, young man? What did you think of our church?
young man. That's funny. He doesn't seem to hear me.
Oh, I hear you just fine. I'm just plumb ignoring you.
Faster. Hush. Faster, hush.
Faster, Taylor, you're slow as molasses. You ain't supposed to tell them you're ignoring them. You just do it.
I know.
Well, we would really like to know what you all thought.
Now, preacher man, you really want to know what we thought. Because if you do, we're just going to lay her on the line. And if you can handle the truth.
Grandma, you really don't have to.
No, we would really like to know. We spend a great deal of time on public relations research and aesthetic beauty to help grow our church. If you had to sum it up in one word, how would you describe it?
One word?
One word.
Stuffy.
Born.
Cold. Rude.
I'm telling you, it seems like your church members has been ironed and starched, but there ain't many of them been washed.
But other than that, preacher, we liked it just fine.
Yeah.
So, Miss Taylor, exactly what part of your visit did you find stuffy?
Well, it started when we walked in, and it ended when we left.
Yeah, and not one person at that third church said it was good to have us.
Our people don't want to seem intrusive.
Well, you know that part where you all stood up and everybody turned around and shook hands and everything?
Yeah.
They ain't nary a person, not a nary.
Not a nary.
That shook our hand.
Well, maybe they didn't see you?
Honey, we was wearing our Easter bonnets. How could they miss us?
Touché.
And that's not all, preacher. Hey, something else bothered me about your sermon.
Bring it, Granny.
Well, what bothered you about my sermon?
They wouldn't warn.
Well, I ran out of time.
I guess you did run out of time, because the whole time that's all you done was talk about all the money you needed to buy them stained glass windows.
Well, time got away, and before I knew it, it was 12 o'clock.
And if he doesn't let the people out by 12 o'clock, there's this one man, Doug Alexander, he'll never let us hear the end of it.
Yeah.
I beg your pardon, Preacher Brown.
It's green.
Well, that's all right, because I'm colorblind.
She is. Colorblind.
Pray for her.
Yeah.
Now, look here. It's about these songs we sung here this morning. I got them right here in the bulletin. I surrender some.
Oh, how I like Jesus.
And there should be sprinkles of blessings.
Well, you know, we're afraid if we come across forceful, we'll offend people.
But begging your pardon now, preacher, couldn't you at least said something about the resurrection?
Yeah, there wasn't one thing that was said about the Jesus crucifixion.
That's right.
3 days in the grave, the rolling away of the stone. And if you don't quit nodding that head like some bobble-headed dog.
Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, I guess it wouldn't hurt to at least mention one or two of those things on Easter.
Well, I'm done talking with you. You've asked us what we thought, and we told you. So I'm going to the kitchen and fix this meal so we can eat before sundown.
But now, Miss Taylor, hey, I haven't had a chance to
I've
ask you about your thoughts on the need for those stained.
You had to get them.
She told them like it was.
She did.
Can you go talk to her? Mr. Tippenheimer, you understand our need for these windows, right? You explain it to them.
Well, here at the First Church of the Stained Glass, we pride ourselves on our aesthetics and beauty, and in turn, we hope that will bring people into our service.
Begging your pardon again, Cousin Oswald and Preacher Green, don't you think that just telling people about Jesus and what he's done first teaching people the simple truth of Scripture and the ways of the good Lord, don't you think that would draw people?
You know what? I have an idea. Huh. How about in one of our stained glass windows, oh my, we'll put a picture of that Jesus and everybody will see it. It'll be beautiful. Don't you think, honey? Yes. It'll just be great.
Preacher, y'all have a right to have church any way you see fit. I mean, who are we to tell you all how to have church? You sure I'm checking that head again there a lot there, preacher?
I'm sorry.
Look, I'm getting messy in the kitchen. It is so much fun.
That's great, dear, but don't forget to talk to Mrs. Taylor about
it. I tried, but she keeps changing the subject, but I better get back to it.
Are you married to that thing?
Hello, what is it?
Pastor Green, it's me again. Sorry to keep bothering you.
What is it this time?
I think you need to come down to the church.
Look, I can't come down there right now. I've got new windows in the palm of my hands.
Yeah, but we have people showing up down here.
Showing up for what?
Well, they say they're for, what are they here for? Spiritual counseling.
Spiritual counseling. Well, just tell them that it's Easter. The church is closed.
Yeah, it's not just one or two, though. It's several. They're members of our church. Some of them are deacons.
I'm not sure I understand.
Well, they say they were really convicted about the service this morning.
Convicted? How could they have been convicted? All I talked about was needing money for stained glass windows. Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know how to break it to you, sir, but I'm afraid it's those tailors again.
This ain't good.
The tailors? What do they have to do with it?
Well, they're saying they feel like the Lord spoke to them through that poem that Hillbilly recited, and they're asking questions.
What kind of questions?
Well, questions about the cross and the resurrection. You know, Easter-type questions.
Easter-type questions, huh?
Yes, sir. I don't know what to say. This has never happened before.
Well, thank you. I'm on my way down.
Pastor Green, is everything okay?
What? Yeah. It seems there are parishioners at the church seeking spiritual counseling.
Oh, I see.
I've never thought to have counselors available for something like this.
So, what are you going to do?
Well, I've got to round up some spiritual saints who are really in touch with the Lord, and I've got to do it quickly. Mr. Tippenheimer?
Yes, sir.
Can I borrow the tailors for a couple hours?
The tailors? Them?
Mr. Taylor, it seems your family has inadvertently started a sanctified resurgence in our little church.
Golly.
I'm sorry, Zangbae preacher. We didn't mean no harm.
Elkin, he means you started a revival.
Golly.
A revival? Us?
Golly.
Yes, it seems the poem that Fester shared this morning really spoke to the hearts of the people. There are people at the church asking questions about Jesus and the Easter story.
Golly!
Golly! Pastor Green, while you were on that phone, did anybody even mention anything about, us? We're dressed for it. We're ready. Did anybody say anything about my dress?
Not now. Forget about your dress.
It would really be a big help if you and your family could come down. I'm not sure what I would tell everybody.
Well, Cousin Pete, it's your house. We're your company. Is it okay with you?
Go ahead, Elkin. We'll be here when y'all get back.
Hey, honey. Fester, would it be all right if I make some copies of your poems to hand out at the church?
I'd be honored, Preacher Lavender.
It's Green.
Look, I made biscuits. I never knew the kitchen could be such a fun place, and Grandma Taylor is so patient with me.
That's great, honey, but we've got to get down to the church.
To the church on a Sunday? Is something wrong?
On the contrary, it seems everything is now perfectly fine. I'll explain it in the car.
Okay.
Mr. Taylor? We'll see you at the church.
Sure thing, preacher.
Oh, remind me to get that biscuit recipe.
Yes, ma'am. We'll take care of that.
Well, it is refreshing to see people go to church for the right reasons for a change.
for the right reasons.
But what other reason is there besides worshiping and learning about Jesus?
Unfortunately, there are a lot of other reasons people go to church.
But we won't get into that right now.
You all better get going. Pastor needs all of you.
Yeah, he's right. Pastor, go get Grandma. Granny! I could have yelled. Go get her. Cousin Oswald, are you sure you don't mind us going?
Not at all, Elkin. I mean, you all clearly have a gift. You need to go use it.
Now, what is going on here now?
Just come on, Granny. We'll explain it to you in a truck.
Well.
Come on, Glenda May. I'll race you to the truck.
Don't be crazy. I'm not running in my Sunday best.
That's right. What was that? Hey, come back here. You're cheating. Wait. Bye.
What about my vittles?
We'll take care of it, Grandma Taylor. You go on.
And we'll wait for you all to get back before we eat.
Okay.
You know, I was so embarrassed this morning at church. Just mortified. I didn't even listen to what Fester's poem was about.
Oh, I've got a copy of it right here that Elkin gave to me, if you want to read it.
I feel lonely all of a sudden.
Well, I don't know about you all, but I cannot wait to get into something a little more comfortable.
Are you saying Petunia's dress is too small on you, Mimi?
I am saying nothing of the sort. Anybody could look at this thing and see it's probably a size too big. Oh, goodness.
Don't look now, Mimi. I believe you're being ignored.
Oh, Petunia, get over it, honey, honestly. If we should be mad at anybody, it's that little boutique that clearly sold us a dress from last season. Leftover dresses. Nothing could tour about that.
Oswald, this is the most beautiful poem I've ever read. And I have a master's degree in literature. No wonder it touched so many people. It's like all of a sudden I realize the true importance of what Easter is all about. It's so simple and honest. Jesus came to earth to show us how to live, how to put others first, how to love and how to give. Then he set about to his work that God sent him to do. He took our punishment on himself. He made us clean and new. He could have saved himself, calling angels from above, but he chose to pay our price for sin. He paid it out of love. Our Lord died on Good Friday, but the cross did not destroy his resurrection on Easter morn that fills our hearts with joy. Now we know our earthly death, like his, is just a rest. We'll be forever with him in heaven where life is best. So we live our lives for Jesus. Think of him in all we do. Thank you, Savior. Thank you, Lord. Help us love like you.
Do you all remember what Elkin told us that one time? That the Bible's like a poem, a love poem written to all of us. And if we listen to it and read it, that it can change our lives. Leave it to our Cricket County cousins to make this the most important Easter in the history of our church.
Yeah.
I think we've all learned some lessons today, huh?
Yeah, I learned that there's more to church than trying to find a date.
And I learned that church is not a country club.
I learned that attending church just to be seen is wrong.
I probably learned the most important lesson of all.
Oh, God, that's good.
You know, the Lord has really blessed me. I was so upset about having to change my dress. And I think everybody liked this one more. Don't you?
Come on, let's go check on the food.
I was mad. Guys, where are you going? Listen, I knew about Jesus? Hey.
There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its worth. It sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name.
All for coming out tonight. It's good that we can come together and worship and smile and have a good time tonight at God's house. And without the resurrection, we wouldn't have a reason to do this program tonight. So we're so thankful that Jesus came. Not only did he just come, but he came to die for our sins. Not just one man's sins, but all. So grateful that we can worship a risen Savior. And I pray that you know him tonight. So I'm going to dismiss us in prayer, and then I'm going to have the cast come back out here to y'all to meet shortly afterwards. So at this time, would everyone please stand? And let's go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this time that we have together tonight. Lord, thank you for Easter Sunday, for Resurrection Sunday. We're so thankful, God, that we can worship a risen Savior, not one that's dead, but one that's alive. Lord, we're just thankful for this church. We're thankful for those that are here. God, just bless each one, bless each family, and God, be with us this week and the coming weeks as we prepare for Good Friday and Easter. God, just help us to remember what it's really about. Be with those in need. Be with those that's sick and those that can't be here. Be with our pastor. We pray for him and his family. God, thank you so much for the gift of salvation. And I ask all these things in Jesus' holy and precious and wonderful name. Amen. So at this time, I'd like to have the cast come back out on stage here. And let's give everyone a big hand. And thanks to those in the sound room that helped with sound effects and those musicians too. And Sarah, come up here. Sarah was the director. Natalie, come up here. Let's give them a big hand, too. Thanks to all that helped, you are at liberty. Have a good evening.